There is a welcome party for all new students each term. The rising temperature is changing the wildlife population. The massive accumulation of data was converted into a communicable argument. The key difference between courses is the kind of assessment. The faculty staff are very approachable, helpful, and extremely friendly. The director of the gallery was grateful for the anonymous donation. Students requiring for an extension should apply sooner rather than later. Students have the options to live in college residences or apartments. The designers will complete the plan later today. The dance department stages elaborated performances each semester. We make our countertops with quartz, our clothes with cotton, our windows with glass, and our streets with asphalt because water can't dissolve these materials. They're made mostly of molecules with no charged parts. It would be silly to build, say, windows with something that can dissolve in water, like sugar. Unless you're going to eat them. And lots of the substances that water does dissolve, like washable markers, are things we engineered so that they can be washed away. We've also engineered versions that aren't dissolvable in water for when we don't want them to be washed away. By making sure water dissolves what we want it to and only what we want it to. We've been able to adapt a life to a world in which water dissolves so much stuff. We humans also literally adapted to a world in which water dissolves so much stuff. The outer layer of our skin is built in a way that makes it uncharged and therefore undissolvable. And the membrane surrounding each of the cells inside us has a similar undissolvable layer. So why doesn't the Fed just decide to print infinite $100 bills to make everyone happy and rich? Well, because then the bills wouldn't be worth anything. Think about the purpose of currency, which is to be exchanged for goods and services. If the total amount of currency in circulation increases faster than the total value of goods and services in the economy, then each individual piece will be able to buy a smaller portion of those things than before. This is called inflation. On the other hand, if the money supply remains the same, while more goods and services are produced, each dollar's value would increase in a process known as deflation. So, which is worse? Too much inflation means that the money in your wallet today will be worth less tomorrow, making you want to spend it right away. So, while this would stimulate business, it would also encourage overconsumption, or hoarding commodities, like food and fuel, raising their prices and leading to consumer shortages and even more inflation. Which gas does plant use during the photosynthesis? What do we describe an event which happens once every year? What do we call the path by which satellites revolve around the Earth? What is the book that you write to describe your own life story? What makes a refrigerator or any other electrical devices work?